the more things they fill out, the higher their conversions are going to be and the higher their show up rate is going to be.
We ran an ad recently with them to help you guys, and we had loads of leads. I think it was about 64 leads from it, which was mega. Took payment at the time of booking. So one of our team phoned them, got them booked in, and took payments over the phone. But we've had, for the first time ever, quite a high number of people not turning up, despite the fact they've paid.
Yeah. Question?
So the question is there a step we're missing to make sure people come in, or how would you handle the no-shows? Would you just put them back in again?
You know, Pete, it's such a great question. Rachel, please get ready to unmute yourself in a moment. the reason I say that, first of all, let me say, Pete, great question. I would probably answer your question differently now to what I've ever answered it. And the reason being is probably the first time in history that I've been in business where there's an element of you have to factor in, I don't have a campaign to help you with all the no-shows. It's the first time I've ever been in business where, you know, people are canceling because they've got it, or families has to isolate, or et cetera, and there's not much you can do. And I'm going to talk a little bit about that in a moment. So let's pre-frame that now. Pete, do you remember when you first did New Patient Avalanche, or et cetera, and there was a statement that I don't know if you remember, but it was, and everyone writes this down. I don't know if this is the issue, but normally when I go down no-shows or decrease show-up rate, or when we were able to do live events, people showing up to, it always comes down to this one statement, normally, but COVID's changed it up a little bit. And casualness, can you write it down? Everyone write this down. Casualness leads to casualty. Casualness leads to casualty. And whenever you think you've done enough reminders, reminder calls, reminder texts, reminder emails, you haven't. And your show up rate and your to the day, et cetera, will be in direct proportion to that, to that. I wasn't very much involved with today. As many of you know, I had we had a bit of a challenge in our family of last week. And so I wasn't too much involved today, but I'm willing to bet you got quite a lot. Or if you register for my webinar, I'm willing to bet you got a ton of reminders. How many guys remember that? Yes? You got like eventually you were like, how many of you were like, okay, Ryan, fuck, we get it. We know when the fucking, yes, what I'm going to tell you is if your prospects are not thinking that, Pete, if your prospects are not thinking, fuck, we get it, dude, you're missing the boat. You're missing the boat. And the trick to doing it without coming across, I mean, I pushed the boundary a little bit because of the B2B world, but the B2C world, you'd have to be a little bit more careful than I am. But the trick to doing it is this sentence. This is the sentence. If you don't get hold of someone on the phone, if someone doesn't respond to a text. So it's one point when I was able to control it more, our rule was it doesn't count as a reminder unless you get a response or an answer. So if it's texts, unless you get a response, it doesn't count. Or if it's a phone call, unless you get an answer, it doesn't count as a reminder. So the way to get away with that is just to be super apologetic and just keep going until you get hold of them on the phone or in a text and just say the following line. We never got a response, so I was so worried I had the wrong number.
Great. Awesome.
You know what I mean? That one line, like, I'm so sorry to bother you. I was so scared I got that the wrong number, and then you weren't getting my messages. We never got a response, and I'm so sorry for hounding you. I just was so petrified I'd got the wrong number, and we were, you know, we really wanted to do everything in our power to make sure that we had the best service possible. So that's the first line. Now COVID came along, and now we're not getting. So I'm going to segue here. So that's for new patients. So first of all, you took payment over the phone. Brilliant. How many of you are not taking payment for new patients prior to them coming in right now? Okay, Richard, a bit different in Spain. I've found quite a few people, there's still a trust factor with like taking payment over the phone, etc. I found that a little bit. John, you'll find that often when you start doing that, the fear will often not be the chiropractor, it'll be the team. But let me see, ladies on the call, or guys on the call, I guess. But who's been to a like a top hairdresser recently or a Michelin star restaurant and you had to pay a deposit before you came? Pay. Like, Catherine, freaking heck, like, you gotta pay, baby. Like, You got that they say, hey, listen, we've got limited amount of availability because of COVID, and you have to pay a deposit. Someone booked us in to a Vision Star restaurant, the Hand and Flower in Marlow. We all, we were isolating because we had symptoms, and they were like, too bad. Like, we're a business, you know, we held off tables from not coming in. So you guys have to get over that. And here's the thing, whenever you bring in something, if you do not say the following sentence, it'll be hard to justify. The following word is, write this down, and there's studies on this in a book called Influence, because if you're going to bring something like, hey, we're taking payment over the phone, if you just add the word because, scientifically proven, it really doesn't matter what you say after because, there's a much higher chance of upkeep. So you could go because it's Tuesday and more people would do it. Honestly, it's a true story. You can say, but if you say the word, the study, and if you haven't read the book Influenced by Robert Cialdini, he goes through this, okay? But just by saying that, you could walk, I've seen people do this in Ep, you know, we live in the United Kingdom where jumping in queues is a big no-no. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Like you jump the queue and like tap, you always got like the big guy at the back. It's like tap, 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 you know, oi, where are you going? So no, sorry, it's Tuesday. I just gotta jump the front, it's Tuesday. And they're like, oh, sorry. And I'll let you go to the front. This is, you read the book, it's really fascinating. So Peter, whoever's not taking payment before they come in, just add that in. And it's because of COVID, we either short staffed or we're trying to decrease contact at the front desk, etc. So we're taking all first appointment bookings payment over the phone, or we're holding a deposit. Here's a little tip for you that feel a little bit uncomfortable with it. Here's what we did for a little while, is we asked them to read out their card details. Now, in the United Kingdom, to hold card details, you need, it's not so easy, you know, to store credit card details. It's not that easy. You're supposed to be, anyway, there's legislation around it. So you know what we used to do, guys? We didn't, before we actually started taking the money, we just used to pretend like we were writing it down. So we took no payment. We didn't keep their card details. We just used to go, okay, great, we just need to take a holding deposit. We won't charge your card unless you don't show, because we're so overbooked at the moment because of COVID. Please just grab your card details, and we didn't even write the card details down. Yeah, if you feel uncomfortable charging beforehand, at least do that. Some of you are like sneaky, Ryan, sneaky. So yeah, that's what we used to do. And then Rachel, so Pete, check this out. I've always said to you guys, the power of my inner circle group is not me, baby. It's the group. You're going to learn more from the people on the screen, or when there's a live version eventually sitting at your table than you are from me. Guaranteed, you're going to learn more from the people in the group than you are from me. I promise you. So here's what I'm going to show you is, I know now we're also, Pete, we're segueing. It's the first time in history where I think if you don't go, you should all be going overboard to remind people about regular appointments now. So should every single person in your database be getting a text to remind them about every single appointment? Freaking damn right they should be. More now than ever. But what Rachel and Burry Chiropractic did, they saw that they needed to go overboard. Casualness leads to casualty. And then Rachel, talk us through what you guys did on a daily basis to help decrease no-shows, not of new patients, of everyone. What did you guys do? So just unmute yourself there, Rach.
Hi, everyone. Thanks, Ryan.
Give Rachel an energetic wave. Energetic wave. Go for it, Rachel.
So we've added an extra step in now, and we use a screening questionnaire. So as soon as we make it.
Rachel. So once you've told them the screen questionnaire, I also was aware at some point during the first lockdown, you actually phoned every single person every single day at regular appointments, not just new patients. Go through that first, and then go through new patients, and I'm just gonna quickly give you context with Rachel's about to teach second. So go through regular patients first and then go through new patients. And what Rachel's about to teach second is a concept of, this is the concept. The more hoops you get a customer to jump through prior to the sale, if you will, the higher the conversions and the higher the show up rate, the more hoops, okay? Which means, so what Rachel, and I said that, by the way, I said this exact sentence, I'll never forget Wendy and Alicia said to me, Ryan, you will not believe it. Our conversions for the people that did that one sentence you did, we started doing what Rachel's about to teach you. And our conversions, literally, once they had done that step, were like 75% from like 30%. So how many excited to learn what that one step is? Give me a wave. Awesome. So Rachel, tell us what you guys did. By the way, before she teaches, I will shut up in a moment, I promise. And before she teaches, I want you to note that what she's about to teach is work, baby, work. There ain't no silver bullets in this group. It's work, but freaking hell, is it worth it? So Rachel, those two steps, what you did for regular patients, and then what did you bring in for new patients? Go for it. And Peter, this might be perfect for you.
Okay, so when they announced the first lockdown, the first thing we did was we sent an email to like our whole database, and then every single person that we could grab who was free was on the telephone. So every single appointment for like the next 2 days in advance, we'd call them and say, "Hi, Ryan, we're still open." We'd explain all the things we got in place, like PPE, cleaning, everything like that. Ask them if they got any issues, ask them if they were shielding, anything like that. If they were, we moved their appointments the week after. So we'd schedule them again for another telephone call. We also got our everybody hands on deck ringing everybody. All our DCs sent Loom videos to all their members. So yeah. Individual Loom.
Everyone write down Loom.
Brilliant. Yeah. Individual Loom. We've even started doing that again, Ryan, this lockdown. So as soon as this lockdown was announced again, everyone back on the telephone. And it's this time a lot more people are coming in because they're not as scared, because they know, and they're like, "Oh yeah, thanks for ringing and calling." And then they just come. So it's just brilliant.
Cool. So let's go through the game. In a 2-day window, they phone every single person in the diary, not new patients only, every single person, even if you leave a message. That's a lot of freaking work. But hey, how many of you realize we're doing business in pretty incredible times? Fucking hell, you should be doing unusual stuff now, not usual stuff. And then the next thing is loom.com, everyone write it down, loom.com. Loom.com is a way for you to record a video and send it an email. If you send it via Gmail, it actually creates like a little GIF, if you will, and it embeds straight away. And it's the quickest way, I truly believe. New patient phone calls are great, but very seldom do you, sorry, first adjustment phone calls are great, but very seldom do you get hold of the person actually. And a voice note means the world. But a Loom video, my word, freaking awesome. So Loom video, and the most important thing, from How to Win Friends and Influence People. If you haven't read that book, it's required reading for every human being on the planet. You have to read it, right? It's one, that and Think and Grow Rich, the only two books I try to read every year. But How to Win Friends, the sound of a person's name is the sweetest thing to them in the world. So when you're doing a Loom video, you gotta say their name. "Hey, Mary, I'm just sending you a quick video, personal video, to say I'm so looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. And if there's anything you need, let me know. Your appointment's at X amount of time. See you then." Now, is it going to be you as a chiropractor? Probably not all the time, but depending on where you are in your career, if you want to go from 60 to 100 a week, you're done. We're done, by the way. This is all you got to do. Promise. You're done. It's different phases in the business, right? So that's, if you're already at 300 a week, it's going to be very hard for you to do this, and that's hard to scale. So then you've got other strategies for that. Then you're really going to focus on the strategy we're going to talk about next. So Rachel, tell us about what you started doing. So after hearing me say that sentence, the more hoops they jump through, the higher the conversions. And I remember the story I told the group. Everyone listen very carefully. I told the exact story, and I can guarantee you they can trace 6 figures back to the story. The story was that in a live event, so we don't have this anymore, but when we were doing like health talks, and we're saying headaches, back or back pain health talks, or health talk you're doing, if you were trying to get people to show up, there were two things that were going to increase show up rate. One, were an insane amount of follow up, and two, if you got the customer or the prospect to engage in a hoop prior to show to coming to attend, their show up rate goes through the roof. And that particular example was a questionnaire. Don't make a questionnaire. The more things they fill out, the higher their conversions are going to be and the higher their show up rate is going to be. However, for free events, like we would say, I wouldn't recommend more than three. So I remember at that point, the questions were, and this is how you get your audience to tell you what to speak about. So the questions for the health talks were, what would you most like to, what would make the day a win for you? What's the one question you want answered? What would make the day a win for you? What's the one question you want answered? And then a very important question: on a scale of 1 to 10, how important is your health for you? On a scale of 1 to 10, how important is looking after your health for you? So if the guy fills it out and it's a 10, you know, like, wow, they're really engaged. So that was for health talks, and if they've done that. And then Rachel and their team took that into new patients. So Rachel, tell us a little bit about that, that step you brought into all new patients.
Yeah. So what we do now is, as soon as they've booked in their appointment on the telephone and we've taken a deposit, we tell them straight away, we're going to be sending you a questionnaire to fill out. It's just 10 questions that's like, can you tell me? It's a lot of stuff that we've based this on is Ryan's is alchemy. It's just fab, just like fab. It's like talking about the most people when they've hurt their back, you know, they've only been hurting it for like, it was all 3 weeks ago. I was lifting something in the gym and I hurt my back. It's phrase, it's trying to rephrase their mind and trying to get them focused in on when was the first time you ever had back pain. So if you're asking a question, when was the first time you ever suffered with this symptom, it removes the goalposts. So we were getting to fill out this questionnaire, which was fab, and then we were calling them. And our texiers, we've got five texiers, and they spend all day on the phone, bless them, and then doing Loom videos and stuff. But the what they do is they ring that guest, and whatever is said in that questionnaire, they use that to have a 45-minute conversation on the phone. It is not scripted. It is just, you know, a flow where they try and get as much information as possible. And when that person is spending a long time with you, as Ryan teaches, the longer they spend with you, the more likely they are to book in. And we found when we did this, our conversion rates were just through the roof. It's just fab.
Okay, great, awesome. But have you guys learned something awesome there? Freaking heck. Like, especially like those of you who already got texts. Oh, this is so powerful. Now, Rachel, please write this down. If you guys want to increase your conversions, time with increases conversions. Time between kills conversions. Time with increases conversions. And I'm going to tell you now, time between kills conversions. So how many of you know if you have a day one and then you do the day two a week later, like, shit, right? You guys know what I'm talking about, right? 2 weeks later, conversions are down. But if you do day one, you should have a rule as a team, 48 to 72 hours max. Like day two, 72 hours max, you know? But the next day is huge. Time between kills, time with increases. And here's the concept, is two things I'm gonna teach you now, is when you get a telemarketer on the phone, do you know that their conversions is directly proportional to most importantly, how long they keep you on the phone. That's it. That's all they're trying to do. The longer they keep you on the phone, the more chance you have of purchasing the thing they're trying to get from you. So have any of you ever had, you're going to show your age a little bit with this, but I have actually. Has anyone ever had a door-to-door salesman selling pots and pans, or like the old Kirby vacuum cleaners? Has anyone had anyone like that to your door before? Peter, okay, cool. So Pete, okay, Ian, Craig. So you know what they, so the rule for the vacuum or the pot and pan guy is all he's gonna do is like, he's gonna get his foot in the door, right? So once his foot in the door, they get into your lounge and they're gonna give you a display. Do you know what the only goal is? Quickly unpack all the fucking pots and pans they can find, so that they ship everywhere, so that they're in the house for as long as possible. That's the only goal. The goal is like, holy shit, pull up all the pots, all the pans, and I'm gonna show you the Kirby thing. I'm gonna take it all apart. There's pieces everywhere. Because guess what? It's gonna take me ages to do that, and it's gonna take me fucking ages to pack it up. So, and there's a direct correlation between that and increased sales. You guys with me, yes? Craig, you're thinking like that fast. Now I know I put this shit everywhere. That's why. They're like, I've got to get everything out. I've got to make it as uncomfortable as possible. And I always used to joke, some of you did like, when you do, I used to go, in the early days, often used to go observe people doing health classes and stuff. And at the end of the sale, I always say, send people to the back of the room to go register for appointments when we can do this again. Don't send them to the front desk. because you're basically like giving them the biggest, like, you know how many people, conversions dramatically increase, by the way, when you get into to register or pay for the initial consultation in the same room as the talk, as opposed to sending them to reception. Did you guys know that? Because you're basically ushering them out to the practice. Off you go. Thanks for coming. And you're making it so easy. You want to put a tank in front of the front door if you can. They have to like walk around it. And like, that's what you want to try to do. You know, like, you guys are like, oh, I'm gonna have someone at the door opening the door for you. No, like you had the door like uncomfortable to open. You guys with me, yes? You watch, you'll do like, I can't believe conversions went up. Yep, conversions went up. Just getting to register in the room. And you put the registration, guess what? You push the registration table in front of the door. So it's a bit awkward to walk around it. Somebody like Ryan, you sadistic. Yeah, well, that's the way it works. I learned from some really successful guys. So time with, so all that, Rachel and Burry Chiropractic have taken a concept that is very well done in high ticket sales, by the way, Rachel. This is what they do in high ticket sales. To speak to the guru, whoever, if you do one-on-one stuff, you have to go through I need to go see if you qualify. Yeah. You need a pre-interview to see if you get an interview. You need a pre, and all they're doing is they just go, and they are very well scripted conversations. Those of you that have not done conversion alchemy, I highly recommend you do it. I promise your conversions will increase. And one of the concepts we talk about that, and maybe I'll answer it now, is how to phrase some of those questions so you can be you're better at those things. And as I've gone through my life and lots of sales, etc., the more you steer away from pain, the lower your conversions in some way, shape, or form. And by pain, I mean people do things for two reasons: towards pleasure and away from pain. And human beings, especially chiropractors and dentists and doctors and all those, but especially chiropractors, we really battle to go there. Now, why am I telling you this? Because in your copywriting, by the way. In your copywriting, and we talk about marketing now. So Ellie, where's Ellie? Another conversation. I just wanted to run through, who else? Okay, sorry. Lucy, where's Lucy? Lucy, have you been through copywriting yet at all today?
Not yet.
No, okay, cool. So please, everyone write this down. And then my team are gonna be like, Ryan, you stop wrapping it up. You're killing our day. You need to pre-write this PAS. PAS, problem, agitate, solve. So when you're writing copy, and if you start, when I do write my own emails, which I should do more of, now I've done a lot more of it, is, and those of you not doing at least a weekly email to your list, you just stop everything and just do that. Trust me on this. You make money every single time you send an email. Every time. Even if you can't quantify it, trust me, you are. So if you're in your copy, that's a formula that copywriters use. Problem. What's the problem? The problem is right now that, here's my problem right now. My problem right now is that I'm stuck in South Africa with them talking about, this is how I write copy for my life right now. I'm stuck in South Africa right now, and they are bringing in hotel quarantine in the UK. Have you guys seen that? Have you? Great. So now if I want to sell me on how to get out of here tonight, it would be like, if you haven't been in hotel quarantine, let me quickly explain it to you. Have you ever seen the movie Road Trip when they rode through Europe? Well, that's probably the hotel that we're going to end up in. And not only that, the food, you can only Uber Eats for an entire 2 week. And the only restaurant down the road is Chinese. So you can imagine you have Chinese noodles for 2 weeks. Now add two kids under three to the mix in the hotel room for 2 weeks. Right. Now trying to run two multi seven figure businesses and get a property deal across, two property deals across the line before the end of March. I'm on a plane tonight. Somehow, you guys with me, to avoid the hotel. That's how you create a bit of pain with that situation. So the solution is, hey, my name is Ryan and I can guarantee you a flight out within 24 hours anywhere in the world. All you gotta do is fill in this little form and I'll see if you qualify, if you're the right fit for me. Now you can do that formula for anything. Problem, here's the problem, agitate it. If you've ever had back pain before, one of the things you'll know is that, you know, this is true, by the way. They did a survey on stage 3 cancer sufferers and extreme sciatic patients. And on the, someone's going to have to give me the name. There's a daily activity scale. On the daily, how it affects your daily activity. Did you know that extreme sciatica and back pain affected daily life? It was surveyed to thousands of patients, was shown to affect your daily life more from a pain perspective and a daily activity perspective than stage 3 cancer. So we underplay just how much it affects people on a daily and daily activity, just so you guys know. Obviously, one's far more severe and life-threatening. I'm not saying, I'm not making that link. What I am making the link of is that if you're not going there, it's in the prospect's mind. And as Dan Kennedy said, you need to enter the conversation already happening in the prospect's mind. So conversion outcome is all about that.